Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new, what up? Today I'm doing my top 10 current favorite scents from Victoria's Secret. I already did the one for Bath & Body Works, so if you guys didn't check that video out, I will go ahead and leave it in the cards for you. And basically, that was just like my top 10 current scents that I have been loving from Bath & Body Works. I did my top 3 of all time favorite scents from Bath & Body Works like a year ago or a little over a year ago, so I'll also link that one if you guys want to see like what my actual all-time favorite top 3 scents are. But the 10 current scents are basically, you know, just scents that I've been loving, I've been gravitating towards, scents that I use like literally every week. Like I pull them out at least once a week to use them, so they are consistently getting used by me. That's basically how I went about picking my scents. And then the ones from Victoria's Secret, because Victoria's Secret does their fragrances so seasonally, like they're always coming out with new collections and new scents and nothing ever really sticks around, I basically picked scents from more recent collections or the core collection that I absolutely love and gravitate towards and really have been enjoying. I tried to pick scents that came from collections that are currently out right now, because I definitely could have picked some scents that came out earlier this year and last year, but they aren't available anymore, so I decided not to do the video in that manner. So I hope you guys are gonna enjoy seeing my top 10 current scents from Victoria's Secret, and let's get into it. Okay, so the first two I'm gonna start off with, these are scents that only come in like lotion or body scrub form. And I'm kind of upset about that because I really wish these scents were like in fragrance mist form, but it's all good because for layering, these work wonders. And the one that I'm about to mention, it is limited edition, so this one is not available right now, but I am hoping, fingers crossed, that they bring it out again this year for Christmas. This is the Coco Christmas Almond Oil Body Lotion from Victoria's Secret Pink. This came out last year during the holidays, and this scent is amazing. So first of all, if you guys are familiar with the pink lotion in general, this is so very thick and whipped. It's very creamy. It's very moisturizing. It is nothing like their original lotions or the Victoria's Secret lotions. This is very thick and it's very hydrating as well. Now, this has a supposedly an almond smell to it, but to me this is very reminiscent of Christmas cookies from Bath & Body Works, and you guys know Christmas cookies has that almond biscotti note in it. So this is just supposed to be a toasted almond scent, and like I said, it's very reminiscent of Christmas cookies from Bath & Body Works. So you could definitely pair this lotion with that fragrance mist, but I absolutely love this scent, and I definitely have pulled it back out since it is, you know, Christmas time, the holiday time, and that's when this came out. So this scent is just amazing to me. It's gourmand and it smells like Christmas cookies, and y'all know Christmas cookies was in my top 10 Bath & Body Works current favorite scents, so I had to include this. Like I said, I know that this is not available currently, but I'm hoping that they bring it out so you guys can try this out. But at the same time, you're not really missing out on anything just because it smells so much like Bath & Body Works Christmas cookies. But I thought I would mention it anyway because it is my favorite scent. Okay, so the next one, again, is in that same pink lotion form. This one is Honey Cranberry. Now, this one is new, and this one is out currently. And I'm assuming that this is the one that they're going with for this holiday season, which is fine because this smells divine, you guys. Honey and cranberry goes together very well. This is just like a fruity, bright burst of a really sweet, very concentrated cranberry type of scent. But it has a softness to it from the honey. This is very, very, very pretty, very smooth. It's not like a super, super tart or tangy cranberry, because sometimes I don't really like those scents. I can get tired of them really fast. But this is definitely very pretty, a creamy, fruity type of scent. And I actually think that this is really nice for the holidays. You smell kind of festive. You smell kind of like a holiday mixed drink. It's just very pretty. So it says, smooth on glowing hydration with a burst of cranberry extract and nourishing golden honey. Y'all, this is super juicy, sweet, fruity. It's very pretty. And I also have it in the oil. And you guys know I love this oil. I've spoken about the regular honey oil from Victoria's Secret Pink that I have. But the oil in this is really good. It gives your skin a nice glow. It moisturizes. It hydrates. All of that good stuff. And the scent, this scent right here, has definitely been a favorite of mine. If you have not tried this scent out, I definitely recommend it. I think this would make a really nice gift, because like I said, it does, to me, smell smell festive. So just very pretty, a very, very nice scent. Can't go wrong with this one, and it has been a favorite of mine. So now moving into my actual sprays, we have Bombshell Passion. You guys, from the moment that I smelled this scent in store, I knew that it was going to quickly become a favorite of mine. This smells very high class and expensive. Like, this gives me sexy woman, but this gives me boss woman. It's just a very expensive smelling bombshell. And I do very much so want the perfume for this, so I might get it for myself for Christmas, because like I said, this is really the only bombshell scent that I myself really, really like. To me, this fragrance smells like me. Like, it smells like something that I would love to wear. And so that is why I have been loving Bombshell Passion, and that is why it's in my current favorite. So I'm gonna get the one scent from the core line out of the way, because I have spoken about this scent so much since I started doing my fragrance videos that y'all are probably tired of hearing me mention it. But Warm and Cozy, y'all already know Warm and Cozy is a favorite of mine, will always be a favorite of mine. The smell is just intoxicating. It is so sweet, but it's soft and it's creamy. I don't think this is juvenile at all, and I'm telling y'all, any and everybody who smells this scent will love it on you. I promise you, I have not gone around anybody wearing this scent that I didn't get a compliment or that I didn't have people all over me. I promise you, this one is just, it's just so crowd pleasing. It's ridiculous. And I feel like this will always, always, always be a staple in my collection. And this is one of the longest lasting scents from Victoria's Secret, period. Like, one of the longest lasting scents from the brand, period, that lasts all day, stays on your clothes, stays on your skin. It's just, you cannot go wrong with this one. It is very, very good. And just like last year, I was wearing this a lot during like the holiday season, because Warm and Cozy, the name implies everything that this is. So I think it's just really nice for you to wear during the holidays, period. So yeah, it's a favorite. I have three here from the Untamed collection, so I'm just going to mention them all together. We have Pure Seduction Untamed, Love Spell Untamed, and Bare Vanilla Untamed. In my vanilla products video, I mentioned how Bare Vanilla Untamed has been a favorite of mine. When I wear this, I get this creamy marshmallow note. I don't know why, but the more that I smell this and wear it on my skin, to me, it does not smell woody. It doesn't smell masculine. I definitely don't get no apple blossom, which is what they say is in the notes. To me, this smells like a creamy cashmere vanilla with marshmallows. That is all I get. And every time I wear this, like, I just feel wrapped in a nice, soft, fluffy marshmallow cloud. And I have been absolutely enjoying this. To me, this is what Fireside Flurries should have been. So this does smell like Fireside Flurries. So I feel like if you like that scent from Bath & Body Works, you would love this. But in Fireside Flurries, there is something really sharp in it. And I know it's the lavender. I know it's the lavender, because you guys know I am not a lavender fan. But Bare Vanilla Untamed does not have that. So to me, this just smells like a nice, soft, cozy, marshmallow, fluffy scent, and I have been absolutely obsessed with it. So Bare Vanilla Untamed. And then we have Pure Seduction Untamed. I already told you guys like why I love this one. So again, this one, when people smell this one, they say that the dry down of this one has a Bonfire Bash, sweet whiskey type of feel to it, like in the dry down. But to me, like I told you guys, mostly what I get from this when I smell it from the cap and when I put it on my skin, this smells like Pure Seduction Decadent. And y'all know that it's like my all-time absolute favorite scent from Victoria's Secret, top three. It's definitely in my top three, and that is what the opening of Pure Seduction Untamed smells like. I just get that really heavy, sweet, fruity, juicy, almost puree type of fruit scent from Pure Seduction Untamed. And then I feel like it does have like this earthy smell to it, but it's not smoky like Bonfire Bash, and it doesn't necessarily have the same scent as Sweet Whiskey, but I do see why people compare it to that. So Pure Seduction Untamed is still a favorite of mine. I absolutely love it, and I definitely recommend it because it is heavy on the fruity sweet scents. And y'all know I love my fruity sweet scents. Same thing with Love Spell Untamed. This one is a favorite of mine because it definitely smells like a fruity puree nectar type of scent. And Love Spell always has this kind of apricot or peachy type of scent to it, and I absolutely love it. But with Love Spell Untamed, it has an added freshness to it because it has forest pear, so it has an added freshness to it, but it still maintains that really syrupy, fruity, sweet smell from the apricot nectar in here. So that is exactly what Love Spell is to me. It's a fruity, syrupy, sweet scent, and I love it. Majority of the time, I do really like the Love Spell flinkers, so I just had to include this one because I love it. And then we have Wild Cherry from Victoria's Secret Pink. I've mentioned this one a couple of times, so y'all probably already knew that it was gonna make it into this current favorites video. But this one is dark cherry pink honey. I've already told you guys that this is a very sexy cherry scent. This is a womanly cherry scent. It just smells luxurious and deep and mysterious and sexy and sweet. It is all of the above. I would high key take this out on a night on the town for sure, for sure. Might mix it in with another perfume, but to me, this does give me perfume vibes. I'm telling y'all, it's a dark cherry in here. They did this scent so well. This is one of the best Victoria's Secret pink fragrances from like their seasonal collection. This is one of the best ones that I've smelled in a while, because this one actually smells like it would have came from the Victoria's Secret side. So I'm gonna always recommend Wild Cherry. Again, if y'all see this at SAS, go ahead and get it, because I'm definitely gonna buy a backup of it. It's good. And then the last two fragrances that I want to mention, these are both from the same line. These are from the Euphoria collection. So Jasmine Cassis and Patchouli Rose. Typically, I am not a heavy floral scent type of person, but these have just enough fruit in them, just enough sweetness in them to where I absolutely love them. Patchouli Rose, this is a very modern rose, a very expensive smelling rose. This is peach and rose mixed together. It also has some patchouli thrown in there, but the patchouli in this is not heavy at all. Like, this is a really nice mix of all of the notes in here. Like, I feel like they did the ratios in this body spray really, really well. So you get the rose, you get the fruitiness from the peach, you get the sophistication from the patchouli, and it smells good. It's not dirty, it's not outdoorsy. It smells good. It's perfumey, it's sweet, just very, very feminine, easy to wear type of scent. This could definitely be everyday signature scent worthy. Same for Jasmine Cassis. I just really, really like this because this is, again, another fruity, syrupy, sweet smell, but it has that floral note in it to keep it from being really sweet and juvenile. And I feel like, again, they did the ratios in this body spray nicely. This is so, so nice. It's clean smelling. Like, it definitely has a little bit of a soapy, airy cleanliness to it, but then it also definitely has that fruitiness to it. The passion fruit and the cassis really comes together to kind of give it that syrupy, sweet feel. So I feel like it's balanced with the cleanliness, the floralness, and the fruitiness. It's just a really, really nice fragrance mist. Again, signature scent, everyday worthy. I feel like they did really nice with this Euphoria collection. Even though I don't have the other two scents, I just feel like this was a really, really nice grown up, on your grown-ish type of collection if you're into that. So these are really, really nice. And again, they are current favorites of mine. So that's everything, you guys. Those are all of the mists that I want to mention from Victoria's Secret for my top 10 current favorites. I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys have the same current favorites as me, because y'all have definitely told me in the other videos that I've done mentioning these fragrances that you're absolutely in love with them. So I would love for you guys to leave all of that in the comment section below. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a big thumbs up. Leave me a comment down below letting me know that you enjoyed it. If you're new, thank you so much for watching. Sis, you should definitely go ahead and hit that subscribe button, join the Fragrance and Beauty Army, as well as that bell notification so that you can be notified every single time that I upload a video. And I'll see you guys in my next one. Peace.